again, everybody. Welcome back to the Carol McRae Show here at North Greenville University, where Christ makes a difference. Well, Coach, it appears that last week's sack opener at Tuscan was like a big salad bowl. You had a lot of really good goodies going on. You had great offense, a defense that caused turnovers, a freshman quarterback with a big passing game, and a late lead. But it just seems like there was one ingredient missing, a big victory.
Well, that's true. We certainly did a lot of things in a positive way. We had a lot of guys make a lot of plays, but we came up short. And then really after evaluating offense and defense and taking a real good look at it, we had about five or six plays where we had mental lapses and some people tried to do too much, really, and got a position defensively a couple of times that really hurt us. And then offense, we had a couple of breakdowns, two big turnovers in the red zone that cost us. And turnovers always come back and prove to be your demise. So, you know, some lapses there, plenty to talk about, plenty of real positives. That's why you don't want to do too much on stat sheet. You win stats, but the scoreboard's what you're going to be evaluated on. So we're still looking for that victory on the scoreboard, and we're going to have to regroup a little bit and really be honed in this week.
Well, North Greenville dropped a 33-21 decision to the Pioneers in Tennessee last week. The score really doesn't do justice to how close that game really was. I mean, you had the ball, you were the lead, 21-20 with 9:46 to go in the ball, ready to go down the field and try to win it. Then you had a turnover.
Well, we did, and our guys really did a good job. You know, we scored to tie the ball game, and then they ran a kickback on us all the way to the 8 and scored on us there, which put us in a bind and really a down for our guys. You know, after you have a big score, it was such an emotional game. That's what's great about college. And then we came back and blocked their extra point and almost ran that back. So even with that being said, yeah, we're sitting there. If we score, we got a chance to go up by one, and then we're going to go for two, try to make a three-point game in case they got back in scoring position. I still thought we were going to win the game, but it was big play after big play, some positives for them, some positives for us, and we let it slip away late because of some turnovers. And, you know, like I said, late in the ball game, when you really got to hone in, when you get it tight in the fourth quarter, the good teams that win late are the ones that can really stay focused, make a play, but more than that, not make a mistake and get out of position.
That's like in my favorite movie, Remember the Titans. Coach Boone always said, fourth quarter. But you really had a chance there. It was a third straight road game. That didn't help any, but you really had a shot at them late.
Well, we did. And, you know, Coach DeBus got a good football team, a really powerful offensive team. They were leading the country in offensive stats when we got there. The quarterback's outstanding player. And, you know, defensively, we did a really good job until the fourth quarter. And then that's when I think we had a 75-yard play and a 60-yard play. One was a pass, one was a run. And that really put us in a bad situation there. So things we can build on. There's certainly things that we can build on. We must build on to move forward. And there's certainly things that we need to eliminate, throw away. We don't want to see them anymore as we come home to play.
Of course, I hate to repeat myself, but Freddie Martino had another big game. He had two touchdowns for you again, just like the previous week, four touchdowns in 2 weeks against some pretty good teams.
Well, he really did. You know, he caught a pass for a touchdown. He ran one in for a touchdown. And to be honest with you, if he hadn't overthrown Taylor Malfris, he would have actually thrown for a touchdown. Just a little bit out of his reach. We had a good play called down, a little trick play, and Freddie overthrew it. But an outstanding game by him. We're starting to move him around in more and more spots, playing him in the backfield, playing him at wing, all the spots on a receiver core, so that when he draws attention, at least we can get some other people open. But 10 draws a crowd, and when he gets the ball, he's pretty excited. He's fun to watch.
And give him a few more reps at quarterback, too, probably.
Well, he needs to practice that a little bit, I think, because he didn't throw that ball too good. But he is an ex-quarterback, I think, and I think he probably could do that if we asked him to.
Well, your freshman quarterback, Joey Carter, had a pretty good game. He passed for 235 yards and rushed for 62 yards also. So a little bit better performance from your young signal caller there.
He's gotten better every week, and we're really pleased with the direction he's headed. Certainly some young mistakes are out there that we have to eliminate. We turn the ball over a couple of times, and we really got to take care of that football if we're going to win. But he made a lot of strides, and probably I'm more tickled about his improvement in the run game because I know the pass game will come. And he's really hitting some different receivers, threw the ball to the back a couple of times, tucked the ball away, ran the football, got first downs, you know, with his legs, made some good decisions where he wouldn't put it in traffic to cause a negative play for us. So those are the things I'm really looking for as he continues to improve if he's going to, you know, be a quarterback to continue to step forward. But, you know, Tyrell Hillary got in there. We were able to play him some as well. So playing both those guys has been a positive for us. And Joey has stepped forward each and every game. Such a good place.
Well, sometimes it just takes time for a young team to get enough experience, get on the field against some good teams to see how that progress comes along.
Well, I think so. I told the staff this morning, you know, our deal, we got some really old guys. We got a group that are really here, been here a long time, and a really group of really young guys. And we're trying to get, you know, that young bunch. We're trying to get them to come together and really be a good football team. We're making strides in that. We certainly got some ways to go, but we played some more, you know, took some more freshmen on the trip. Didn't go week four. And, you know, I'm just encouraging our staff, continue to put them on special teams, get them in the offense, defense. Let's play the guys we need to play to move forward and win games.
Coach, your defense played pretty well against a veteran Tusculum team. I remember how good they were last year. They converted several plays for big points. And they had some that made the difference in almost winning that game for you.
Well, they did. You know, Braylon Meredith had a big interception. We got back to the 50, and our offense took it on in and scored. You know, we had some really big plays. I think we had quite a few tackles for a loss. Stephon Bino certainly was playing on their side of the football a lot. And that was encouraging to see. But we had some guys make some big plays. And I think our defense will continue to do it. We can stay healthy from this point and continue to bring our young guys along. I think we're going to proved to have a really good defense in our second
quarter. A.J. Jones led you in tackles with 9 this past week. Stephon Bino was, and Michael Klein had 7 tackles, 3 for loss. So you've seen a lot of different guys starting to contribute.
Well, we really are. And certainly on defense, it takes, you know, 11 guys working together to make sure you hold down an offense like they have. And our priority number one, you know, was to stop the run game, continue to make them throw the football. We did a real good job of that until the one long run they had in the fourth quarter. But other than that, we contained their backs. We contained their short screen game, which had been so important for them. And, you know, got after their quarterback pretty good. He had a quick release, and he threw the ball quite a few times, you know, when we had him in our grasp. But our guys got after him. I think we'll continue to take steps forward because I know the character of our guys playing.
Well, Coach, one of the best backstories of college athletics is how coaches and players prepare for a game. Let's take a look at some of the rituals and traditions of the North Greenville football team.
Pioneer Gear. College bookstore.
Yeah! 3-on-3! 3-on-3! 1, 2, 3! Crusaders! Compete! What's that sound you want to get loose? What's that sound you want to get loose? Let them right there!
Let's go.
Three. Every drop of sweat and blood comes down to us first then. 60 minutes to prove what we got. Every fiber of your body, mentally and physical, one play at a time, over and over and over. If you can't go, let us know, because we'll get another one in and then get you right back. We want the freshest, toughest, meanest men we got on the field every time that ball snaps in all three phases. You come in your game. You make plays. You do your job. And most of all, you have a big time having fun together. You got it? All right, what you got, Kevin?
Somebody. Lord.
Lord.
Help us come close together as a team.
Help us come close together as a team.
Pull for one another.
Pull for one another.
Deep down in our hearts.
Deep down in our hearts.
Help us to accept the good times.
Help us to accept the good times.
And the bad times.
And the bad times.
As one team.
As one team.
Give us love for one another.
Give us love for one another.
As needed.
As needed.
To accomplish our goals.
To accomplish our goals.
The Lord is my shepherd.
The Lord is my shepherd.
I shall not want.
I shall not want.
Coach, who do you have for the Off the Stat Sheet Award this week? That one player that may not have the big numbers, but really contributed on the field.
Well, the guy that's stood out to me is really an unselfish player, Ben Ferris. And we lost Zach Eckstein, our starting nose guard in the Albany State game. And Ben's been pushed in a role to go in and play nose guard. You know, and we've got two really strong defensive ends in there. And that old nose, he gets doubled and triple teamed a lot. And Ben just, you know, gets in there and does his job. Plows around in there, ties up blocks, so our linebackers like A.J. and those guys can make plays. And really, you know, he's a guy that stood out as being a guy you can really count on. He's reliable, comes to work every day, and does what coaches ask him to do. So I think he's a guy that fits that mold of what we're looking for today.
Well, Coach, during the last three seasons of working with the North Greenville football team, I've seen this rivalry build. We saw him several years ago here. We played him twice last year. You got the Mars Hill Mountain Lions coming to Yount Stadium this weekend. The rivalry continues to grow, but you know, they beat us in the regular season, yet we went up to Mars Hill and beat them in the second round of the NCAA playoffs. I know they're looking forward to coming down here as well.
Well, there's no doubt. And Coach Clifton's done an outstanding job in Mars Hill. He's been there forever. And I think it's over 20 years now. And he's really, you know, put them in the mold of just reloading every year, you know, getting themselves into their targets, go to the playoffs, win the SAC championship, and continue the tradition he set. And they're a big, tough, physical football team. So I know those two games last year, you know, one went for them in the playoffs, it went toward North Greenville, and you know, they'll have a football team to be ready to go. Interesting thing about them, they played two 1AA teams, and then they played Brevard this past week. So they've had really good competition. You know, they beat Brevard pretty handily on Saturday, and they don't hide what they do. We pretty much know what they're going to do. They don't mind lining up, telling you what they're going to do, and then they see if you can stop us, you know, with your defense. And then defensively, they got some good, fast guys that run around pretty strong up front. So it'll be a good challenge for us. Although I'll tell you, you know, I think our guys, if we can eliminate the mistakes we've had and get better this week and have the effort that we continue to have in the fourth quarter, both physically and mentally. Mentally is where we lapsed. I think we'll have something to say about the ball game. I'm hoping the fourth quarter again this week, and that's what we're looking for again.
Well, that's coming up this Saturday, September 22nd, when North Greenville takes on the Mars Hill Mountain Lions at Yount Stadium. Kickoff of that game is at 7 o'clock. And if you should, by chance, you can't make it out to the game will be broadcast live on My40 television out of Asheville, North Carolina. So all throughout the North Carolina and South Carolina region, you'll be able to watch it on television. So that's going to be exciting as well.
Well, it is. You know, our administration made a great commitment for our first home game to make sure it's where a lot of our fans can see it, or a lot of fans coming back from the other schools around the upstate can come home and sit and watch the Crusaders. So it's a big time for us. It's quite an honor to play on TV, and it's a big time for our players to be able to be showcased like that against a good team like Mars Hill.
Well, it's also Family Day at North Greenville, so a lot of our young people will be coming back. Their parents will be here for their freshmen. We'll have a lot of people in calendar day, so we hope to have a huge, raucous crowd coming up this Saturday night.
Well, there's no doubt, you know, the home crowd advantage is something we've been looking forward to. We faced a lot of ugly foes the last 3 weeks, so we're looking forward to a lot of people wearing black and red and white and cheering for the Crusaders.
Well, Coach, you don't have to go on a bus ride this weekend. You can stay at home before the game. Okay, well, so we'll look out to see how it comes out with North Greenville and Mars Hill coming up this Saturday. So with Coach Carroll McCray, I'm Fred Battenfield, and this is the North Greenville Sports Network.